The robotaxi industry may still be in its infancy, but competition is already heating up among Chinese firms. They're now planning to deploy thousands of robotaxis around the world over the next 3 years. WeRide is partnering with ride-hailing giant Grab to deploy their vehicles in Southeast Asia. They've begun testing in Singapore, eyeing rollout by the end of this year. Europe's also being targeted ahead of an expected easing of regulations by next year. Baidu's Apollo Go has partnered with Lyft to bring robotaxis to the continent, starting with the UK and Germany by 2026. And Momenta has teamed up with Uber for tests in Munich. But it's the Middle East that's emerging as the hotspot for robotaxis, with three of the biggest Chinese players racing to establish operations in the UAE and Saudi Arabia. We travel to the UAE to take a look.
I'm here in Abu Dhabi, just about to board one of these robotaxis operated by WeRide and Uber. This is a GRX, which comes with more than 20 sensors, including LiDARs, cameras, and radars, helping it to navigate its environment. So we're here on our way to one of the destinations, part of WeRide and Uber's coverage area. As you can see, there's a safety driver in front of me, but his hands are not on the steering wheel because the car is steering itself. WeRide also has presence in Dubai, Riyadh, and Saudi Arabia. This makes them one of the front-running robotaxi players in the region. Other Chinese companies such as Pony AI and Baidu Apollo Go are also flocking to the Gulf countries. They like these markets not only because they can charge higher fares than at home, but there's also not as much public backlash yet. Many of the ride-hailing or taxi drivers working here are guest workers, so they have less influence on policies. This here is Dubai's first autonomous driving trial license plate, and it's been put on a model of RT6, Apollo Go's latest offering. I had a go on one of these in Beijing. It comes with voice controls, massage function, and reclining seats. We could soon see more of these in Dubai because the Emirate targets 25% of their trips to be smart and autonomous by 2030. Pony AI is also doing trials in Doha, Qatar, and WeRide is also doing testing in Riyadh and Saudi Arabia.
What we're focusing is where we can deploy the most number of AV fleet on the road and to bring the benefit of autonomous driving vehicles to the local community. It's definitely much safer, more efficient. So if autonomous driving can help them to bring down those costs and have like less road accidents, it's definitely our mission for that to happen.
While US firms are almost exclusively focusing on their home market, Waymo has begun collaborating with Japan's Go Taxi app, using human drivers to help train its autonomous driving technology in Tokyo. They began testing in April. Japanese car makers are also getting into the self-driving game, with the potential of eventually throwing their hats into the robotaxi ring. Suzuki is working with self-driving tech startup Tier 4, Toyota and Waymo are working together, and Nissan is working with UK-based AI startup backed by SoftBank, Wave Technologies.
You know, we have aging society in Japan. Many people will need some assistance moving from point A to point B, and this is where driverless technology can help.
I'm in a Nissan Ariya with the latest ProPilot system developed with Wave's AI technology. This car has level 2 autonomy, which means it can steer and accelerate, but still needs a driver to monitor the roads. Japan has strict regulations requiring a human on board to take over if needed. Full self-driving technology is still years away here in Japan. Nissan, though, is trying to stay ahead. It says the ProPilot system rivals that of Tesla's technology. It's already conducting driverless trials in the UK, here in Japan, since 2017. In China, it's partnering with WeRide in order to develop robotaxi services. Bloomberg NEF says we'll see a robotaxi fleet about 6 million strong on the roads by the next decade. And with many of these projects scheduled to deploy across the world in the coming year, VRL robotaxis may be arriving soon to a city near you.
With Linda Liu in Dubai, I'm Sherry Ann for Bloomberg in Tokyo.